I'm gonna do, when I'm here, it's hard for me to pull his arm, his elbow open. I switch my grip. Now I can really pull his elbow open and stay in base here. Okay, so that gives me better rotation. Now when I'm here, I'm gonna roll through. Oh, you.
Jiu-jitsu is just something else because it's so much, you gain so much mentally from it. The learning aspect of it, constantly wanting to grow and evolve in jiu-jitsu is what compels me to keep training. Just the spirituality, the self-improvement of it all. I'd never planned on competing or even become a serious practitioner at the beginning. I was just trying it for fun. I know competition's not for everyone, but at that moment I felt like, okay, this is something that I think I want to keep doing. I'm a chef by trade. Originally I wanted to become a culinary instructor because I really enjoyed teaching things that I love. And I was finding I had the same passion for teaching jiu-jitsu. When I got my purple belt, I started teaching at the club I was training at. I just realized I wanted to cook less and train more and teach more and really focus on helping people improve their jiu-jitsu. And now that I have my own club, I get to do that for a living, and it's a dream come true.
Now this, look at this, this is a little loose. So try and bring your left knee to your body and your body to your left knee. So you create, yeah, you see how it traps that now?
A few years ago when I was, you know, just at work and I was just thinking, you know, I just want to be spending my time on the mats and just, that's where I want to be. How can I make that my life? And so I was actually training with my really good friend and one of my good coaches, Mike Lee. We started talking about the idea of maybe having a school. I told him, I have a really big interest in teaching. It's something that I think I want to do, and I want to get away from cooking. And then he said, yeah, well, you know, I can help you with that. And just instantly we started coming up with a business plan. We were just renting out a space in a Taekwondo gym, and it was very small at first, but then people started coming in and we were able to move locations, and we actually moved to our third location, which is now in Pitt Meadows, and I have a full studio and, you know, classes are filling up. So, you know, 3 years goes by real quick. I think the idea of investing your time into someone and then watching them grow is a really it's a really fulfilling thing for me, and I think that's why I enjoy teaching so much. I enjoy cultivating quality when I teach. So when I see a student do something that's wrong and I correct them, and then they, you know, I see the improvements next time, that's really where I get fulfilled, when I see them improve, because I know that, you know, I'm a part of that. I find that the systems we use tend to help people get to a higher level a lot quicker. I think that it gives them a problem-solving code. When they go into a grappling situation, they can just look for, you know, look for levers and look for frames and all these things, rather than looking for their favorite moves that they tend to fall back on. I've been influenced by my professor, Rob Bernacki from Island Top Team, who has instilled a concept-based approach to jiu-jitsu that relies on human body mechanics and alignment. I think that conceptual based approach is really what sets us apart. And then of course, you know, we have our leg lock system from Island Top Team, which is a really fantastic system. And we really strive to cultivate the highest quality we can. People should do it because it's hard. People should do it because it's challenging and it will test you. And there's gonna be days when you don't wanna do it. That's why you should do it, because it's hard to find things in life that are so rewarding and are so good for you, both mentally and physically. For me, it really just gives me that centered spirituality that I need to be able to be a happy person. And I've truly found meaning in my life studying and teaching jiu-jitsu. And I think that, you know, so many people out there that aren't ready to try it, or maybe they're a little bit intimidated, I would just say, you know, you're never gonna gain anything just by sitting on the couch. When you're in there defending yourself and you're practicing fighting for your life, it's a really primal, amazing feeling, and I think everyone should be able to experience that.